Hi there, thanks for joining us. I'm Chris McKinnon with the WBZ News Update. Families whose lives changed forever when a driver crashed into a West Newton pizza shop are sharing their painful stories today.
The weight of such grief is not something you can understand unless you've experienced it yourself.
The driver is considering pleading guilty, but the judge wanted to hear from the families first. 55-year-old Bradford Kassler is facing several charges, including two counts of motor vehicle homicide. Prosecutors say on March 1st, 2016, Kassler was speeding when he lost control of his SUV and hit the Sweet Tomatoes pizza shop. Two people were killed, seven others injured. Prosecutors want Kassler to serve 5 years. Kassler has multiple sclerosis, but prosecutors say that did not cause the accident. The judge plans to hear medical testimony before making his recommendation. The NFL says it found no evidence Patriots quarterback Tom Brady suffered a concussion during last season. In May, Brady's wife, Gisele Bündchen, told CBS This Morning her husband suffered several concussions over the course of his career, including one last year, but no concussion was ever listed on an injury report. The NFL says a review of Brady's medical records, game film, and reports from spotters found no indication Brady sustained a concussion or reported any symptoms. And a rescue in the Linwoods. Fire crews had to help a woman out from the bottom of a 40-foot ravine this morning. Paramedics took the victim to Mass General. She is expected to survive. Want to check in with meteorologist Pamela Gardner this noon for a look at our forecast. Hey, Pamela.
Hey there. We have another round of rain and storms in the forecast, at least one more this afternoon, and then another round overnight tonight into tomorrow morning. So we're not done just yet. Flash flood watches continue until 6 a.m. Thursday, 1 to 2 inches per hour with any storm that does develop and move through. Here's your hour by hour as we go through this afternoon. The evening commute, very soggy, and lots of lightning with any of these storms too. Gusty winds, maybe an isolated severe thunderstorm. As these storms and showers push north and east, we'll slowly see temperatures fall just a little bit into the upper 60s overnight tonight, down into the mid 60s, and the humidity still pretty high, allowing for additional showers and storms to move along this frontal boundary. The front starts to push out by tomorrow, and that means as we get past the morning commute on Thursday, things start to brighten up Thursday afternoon. But it looks like localized flooding will again be the main impact from anything that moves through. Damaging wind gusts, perhaps, in some isolated storms. Overnight tonight, 64 degrees with more of those showers, so probably want to keep the windows closed. Your game day forecast for the Patriots Thursday evening, looking good. We get all the rain out of here for early in the morning, clearing, less humid by kickoff, 66 degrees, cool and dry as the Pats wrap up a win. And here's your 7-day forecast. More 70s on the way for Friday, 73, Saturday, 68, but then up to 70 on Sunday. Chris?
I like the confidence, Pamela. Wrapping up after a win. Thank you very much. I'm Chris McKinnon. This has been a WBZ News Update. Have a great day.